All right, I
There you
finally
go.
finished, and I didn't find some items. Oh, hey, Umbra. I'm gonna go over to the liquid emerald shop just 'cause to see what that is. You wanna come on? All right. For the Lord of Heaven, that I never thought my eyes would get to see this again. What? What are you talking about? It's the great almighty Dedalus and his companion Anduris. What? No.
Endurance.
Her name is Umbra, and my name is Arbiter. What are you talking about?
Yeah,
Oh,
he's a dog.
yeah, I'm a dog. What the heck? I'm not. I'm. Why am I? Why? Why? Why are you calling me a city? Oh, you guys just look identical to the Windcraft legends, Anduris and Dedalus. Wait. So we look exactly like a guy named after a city that's named after a guy, and
Is
well,
she are
then
is
that
she
ran
telling
and.
Hold on, hold on. Fine.
What do you
I
mean?
just read his mind.
He's not
He's read
lying?
his
What do you
mind.
mean? We look exactly like them?
Is this some kind of coincidence?
Like, there's no way we can be exactly
Asking
like
him.
them. You know what?
Asking
Since
him.
you don't believe me, I might as well just tell you a tale then. Oh, you know what? I mean, we're not doing really anything. Why not? Just a tale. But can you tell us more about these two people we're talking about? Of course. So, the Great Dedalus, named after this Dedalus city, was the best and most righteous marksman of his time. Also, really good with dagger. And Anduris was the best mage and healer you could find at the time. Both
Wait,
companions.
that dagger I gave you from the mysterious traveler.
Oh, wait, show this one?
Show it
Oh
to him.
my! If that isn't. Where do you find that? Yeah, Umbro, where do you say you find that again?
Some random traveler came up to me, gave me this, said it was from a, it said it was from a man, said that I was to give this to you. And that you look like a man that he remembered from a time long since past, and also that I had pretty hair.
Could it be? Could it be what? No, I don't think it is. But you there, boy, you have Dedalus's dagger. Oh, wow, sweet. That's pretty honorable that he would decide to give this to me. Yeah, now, as I was saying, I guess I should tell you the tale. One of Dedalus's and Anduris's tale. Now, this started a long time ago. Alright. Excuse me. Oh, what's up? What do you need, Dedalus? Well, I was just wondering, do you know where I could find Anduris? Ah, oh, yes. You know, she's all the way over at Dedalus. Oh, thank you. So pretty ridiculous I got named after a city. God, that's annoying. I guess I should do some arrangements first. Let's see. Let me save my great dagger. Wow, where's my dagger at? Oh, I guess I'll find it later. Anyways, I better should head off to Nemrakt. My good old zombie horse. You've been here with me for a while. You've been through most of my journey. But before I take off, I should probably get some of Dedalus's great ale. Yes. You can't come to Dedalus without drinking its famous ale. Oh, but it's really strong. God, it's well, it gets me super nauseous. Oh boy, this is not gonna be good. I shouldn't have drank that entire thing. Oh, God. All right, come on, let's go, horse. Let's go. Let's head over to Dedalus now. Oh, I don't even know where I'm going anymore. There you go. Let's over to Dedalus. We need to find Anduris, so I can get her to do some sort of. Why do I even bother talking to you? You're just a horse. I don't know why I'm always talking to myself constantly. It's kind of weird, but I guess that's just an issue for me. I've been doing this since like I've been really little. All right, time to head over to Dedalus. Oh no, I can't do this. Oh, too much dizziness. Oh, God. Back off, skeleton. God, I better rest off here. Because I'm way too drunk. There we go. I feel so much better. Alright, time to head off to Detlas now. I'm sure it would make sense that it would make sense that Anduris was here. But now, where could she actually be at? That's something to think about. Where could Anduris be at? Hey, Anduris! Nope. Not here. Could she possibly on top of it? No, I don't think so. Where then? What's this? Where is Anduris at? I don't see her. That out. Anduris, where are you at? Oh, I think I just heard Anduris. Oh! Hey, Anduris. Hey, Anduris! Oh, God! I need to talk to you about something. Can you please listen to me for a second? I need help with something. Come on. It's not fair for me. You know I can't get up there. I'm not an archer.
Would you keep the ruckus down?
I need some help with a laborer. And you're Windcraft's best healer. I'll pay good if you help me. And it's for a good cause.
Who speaks to me? And who interrupts my studies?
The great...
Yet again.
One of Windcraft's finest warriors, Detlas.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, as I was saying...
I was just settling down for my daily study. What is it?
I need some help with a quest... And I was told that you were Windcraft's finest healer, so I decided to call you to help me do it. And if you help me, I'll also reward you with a bunch of liquid emeralds.
Everybody comes to me to ask for help. Everyone comes to me for help. Everyone asks for help. This is the 50th time. It's not new. And... I used to be enthusiastic about this, but this has now happened for the 50th notch damn time in a day.
Well, guess what? This is not only just any sort of quest help. I need your help to help me take on Tower of Ascension, where death is located.
Tower of Ascension. Why would you dare pass by that place?
Because I was told that if we let Death or Tower Suspension keep there, if we don't do something about it, the corruption is going to get so bad that Wynn is eventually going to get corrupted by it. And nobody else is willing to help me do this. So how about it? Are you in on it or not?
Fine. Take me to the location that you desire.
Right.
But I might want to point out that death is not the cause of the corruption.
I'm aware of it. But its huge tower and its mobs surrounding it are a huge impact on the corruption getting so big. I mean, honestly, I've been living in this here for like ever. And I've never seen the corruption so bad.
I've been living here since time immemorial. Not once has any of my hypotheses turned up that the Tower of Ascension was the cause of the corruption. Every single one of them went back to the Nether Portal. And Gavel.
Well, Gavel, their gates are closed. You know that they're closed.
I've been to Gavel.
Well, I've been to Gavel too, but they closed their gates after they saw that their monsters and fairies started getting corrupted. It's something about when. And honestly, even if you claim that Death and Tower of Ascension had nothing to do with it, they're still threatening people's life. You do realize that, right? It's impressive.
Death threatens us all. Death comes to us all.
I know.
No matter
But maybe... I'm aware of that. But maybe we could do something to save other people's lives so they can live longer. You know that town right outside Tower of Ascension? Yeah, it's getting worse every day. It's not getting any better. And you know it.
Yes.
And there's thousands of citizens
they've
living there.
Over the many years, they've come to know the Tower of Ascension as a local monument of the area.
A pretty dangerous monument. Yeah, I've been there many times. And it's not a nice place to be in because it's surrounded with goddamn living monsters everywhere. So, maybe if you...
Either way, take me to the destination. But first, I know that is not your real face. Take off the mask.
I use this mask not only to protect myself, but because it brings me a lot of perks. But here you go. If you really want to see my true face, here you go. Have it.
Go to F3 now.
This is my real face. Now, come on. Let's go.
I just like it when I'm able to trust somebody who actually asks for help.
Yeah, well.
Lead me.
Let's go then. We first gotta make a stop in Nemrak though, because once we make it past that spot, it's gonna be super dangerous. And by the way, through the way, I guess you could read your book. It's not like any sort of monster here can threaten both of our lives. They're pretty weak. Monsters.
See, this is why I spend hours and hours studying. It's to find things like this. I found something that might be very important.
What is it?
And all my previous hypotheses about what's causing the corruption are incorrect.
Oh? So what is causing it? Honduras?
If my new hypothesis that I just sprang up out of my mind is correct, the one who's causing the corruption isn't the portal. The portal has been run down for a really long time, and the corruption from the portal has actually been receding. And the corruption in Gavel hasn't been spreading from Gavel. Thanks to their efforts of closing the doors and keeping all Wayne provinces out of their territory, managed to contain their form of the corruption. No. I think it's something worse.
Oh? What is it?
If I'm correct, the cause is Bob.
Bob? Why would... Oh my.
He disappeared.
Right at the same time as corruption started growing.
The corruption began to grow after his disappearance, and then spontaneously at the same time, it appeared in three different spots at once. If you read this log here in my book,
yeah, what about it?
You not see the line there?
Oh.
Week after the disappearance of Bob, three spontaneous occurrences of corruption, along with three different hordes of mobs, each bearing different kinds of species of mobs, appeared on the same day, with no coincidences.
Could it be that Bob somehow was stopping the corruption from spreading?
That's why I sit down and research these things. Although I've been dragged away now from my research, it's going to be a bit more difficult to do this on a walking trip, though I'm still able to manage it. Just keep on shooting at them and keep them off of my back from pricking me.
Yeah, don't worry. Although these are way much harder, tougher to kill, I can still manage them. After all, they're yet not that powerful. I'm going this way. We're almost. I can see Nisak from all the way over here.
Watch out! Oh, take a powerful one there.
I can tell. We gotta take. There you go. Got him. Now let's go. Let's keep heading off into Nemrock so we can stack ourselves. Ah, the little wolves are so pesky. Although it's pretty messed up for me to call my subkind or my pretty much.
You're a werewolf.
Yeah, it's kind of messed up to call them that way. They're still pretty annoying. And I don't like them. I'm way more civilized.
You're in your lupin phase. And you've been in your lupin phase for the past week now.
I know. But still. They're still pretty pesky. Alright, gear yourself up. Grab some stuff. I'm gonna get some stuff done here at the bank.
I'm already geared up. I wear my gear with me.
Yeah, well, okay, I remember.
It doesn't weigh me down at all.
I know. Alright, so yeah, I might want to grab some potions. Because, after all, it's pretty hard. And, I'm going
to
buy
some. Attention placed only for the bull.
Yeah, I know. So, see, let me get some potions here.
I go only as far as it is manageable.
Don't worry. I'm gonna be the one taking most of the damage. Alright, are you ready to set off? Or not quite? Alright, let's head off.
One last thing.
Of course, potions.
Actually, I was going to purchase potions for you.
Here we are, the Great Tower of Ascension, with its huge and dark spikes. Come on.
Every time I see this structure, it always fills me with both a lightheartedness and also dread.
Yeah.
Because I know who dwells within, and who dwells at the very top.
The death himself.
And I dare not touch his domain.
Well, I will. After all, even if, as you said,
death. Because death is us.
Because even if we, even if we beat death himself, death will come back and get us. So we have to talk to this guy if you haven't talked to him already. Because he's the one who keeps this place and within. Alright, so, I'm guessing you've never been here before, right?
I've been to the Tower of Ascension. I just never went into it.
Alright.
I studied extensively. It gives off a combination of different auras. Namely, water, lightning, and death. Unsurprisingly.
Yeah. Well, I've already cleared one of the floors. But this guy likes to play by a certain rules. And he doesn't let you go through until you clear a floor, so I'm gonna have to help you and then make it to the next floor. So come on, let's go.
I dread the meanings of death.
The meaning of death is to I'm guessing the meaning of death is just to fulfill its own. So here you go, you're just gonna take down the rams. Not shouldn't be such a hard task. So all you gotta do is grab their little things that they drop. You might want to kill them. Have them go for me. Over there, there's a bunch of them over there.
Death is influencing this fight right now. Things are freezing in place. No. This is why I don't come into the tower.
Well,
time is running differently for us.
Tokens. You're supposed to bring a bunch of tokens here to the guy.
My skin.
Hell, go. Get it, Undoris.
Hold on.
What are you doing? Come on.
Death is influencing this. Our time frames are different. He has that power.
Yeah, that's why I want to take him off, because someone with that such great power should be taken down, or else there's going to be bad consequence from it. Alright, do you have enough tokens? How many cold shards do you have?
11.
Alright, I think give them to this crystal
there's
over here.
There's a reason why no one shall ever truly take down death. For death is in us all.
Alright, come on. Did you give them to them?
Yes.
All right, come on through.
You may proceed.
Come through the next floor.
Chickens this time.
Ah, those little chickens, they ain't. Oh God, those are. I keep forgetting how much they sting. Jeez. Ah, you suckers. Those guys can poke you hard. Actually, they can peck you really hard. Jeez. Honestly.
No problem, really.
Yeah.
They're chickens. Oh, no, not chickens. They're owls, actually, to be precise. Their anatomy is just incorrect. Their names are. The chicken. It's split off into different varieties in the biological graphicry of Minecraft.
Yeah. The thing I find really dumb is some people still claim of this as ducks.
Well, they are ducks. They're distant, and they are descendants of ducks. They're used
of course.
To be ducks.
Of course.
They used to be ducks in
but
the land
still.
Of Minecraft, yeah.
They used to be ducks. Everything evolves.
And their existence remains in these chickens.
Yeah. But they're still technically not ducks. So.
Good Minecraft biologists shall remember them as actually being ducks.
Alright. Do you have enough?
Yep.
Alright, come on.
Enough?
Yeah, I've already cleared this floor. I'm just helping you through. Ah, oh, great. This is the part I hate. I'm gonna have to kill cousins. Oh well. Whatever. They're technically.
Kids roll raid. I have no problem with this.
Yeah, well, I mean, although it's, I mean, I would rather not to, I'm still doing because they're serving an evil person.
Evil person? I'd like the disclaimer that death is neither evil nor a person.
Well, an evil, or an entity that does not have good purposes, then.
He has neutral purposes. And he's not just an entity, he's a god. A very powerful one, too. One that in the end takes us all down the memory lane of life.
Do you have enough tokens?
I have seven.
Alright, let's keep going. Well, again, go, kill him.
I haven't done extensive studies into this, but according to those who managed to escape from him, just briefly, before being brought back by him a week later, death would take them down a memory lane of their entire life.
I mean,
he would hold their hand.
Go, get it.
He would hold their hand, and they'd remember everything that they had done and what had happened to them.
Right.
He'd bring them to their conclusions.
All right, let's head to the next floor now. Oh God, not these. God, right, oh God, there's too many of them. Come on, I'm gonna keep fighting. Ah, I'm taking too much damage from this. Jeez. Come on, we got a bunch of them. Oh no. Oh God. Oh God, man, my head hurts.
You know that you would have actually had a better time in there if you hadn't just gone charging in like a hero, and actually been prepared for that, I had to drag you out of there.
Yeah, well, I'm sorry about that.
They overwhelmed you and knocked you out. And thanks to that, they ripped one of my logs out of my book.
Oh.
This is why I study.
Well, see, now this is where I get my knowledge from mistakes. I make a mistake, and I learn not to do it again. This is the first time in, like, Lord knows how long that has happened, and now I learn to prepare better. Besides, yeah. It was a fun experience. It was pretty fun.
Bring back a lot of old memories of old times, and when I was brazen like you. When I was a young spanking ender girl.
Nope.
Those days have long since passed. They passed 1,000 years ago.
Well, that was fun. We should do this some more sometime.
Certainly sounds like a good idea.
That tail was so stupid. Those two guys don't. Those guys don't even like sound like us.
Don't Sound like me?
Detlef is nothing like me. He's drunk. He's a nice person. He doesn't care about money. He actually cares about people's well-being.
I've met that guy before you. You're a big fat jerk. He's respectable. And I haven't read a book since high school.
Is that good or bad? I don't know, but they're like. I mean, she just Honduras doesn't spend her entire time just drinking.
She doesn't drink.
And she's way better. Unlike Umbra, Honduras is way better healing than Umbra. Umbra sucks at healing. She turned me into a frog once while trying to heal me. That's how bad she is. What the heck? Why do you even come up with a comparison? Now that I think about it, the resemblance is not there anymore. Yeah, it's not nice. I don't know why we would ever be compared with such little goody two-shoes.